Hoy tendremos una entrevista con una invitada especial. Para ello les pedimos que por favor activen sus subtítulos. Gracias. Hello everyone. Today we will talk with special guests. But first, we will see quickly about APT products. Welcome to Aqua Dragon Tech, aquascaping to the next level. Okay guys, there we have these products of the 2 Hours Aquas brand. At the first line we have first, like APT Zero, APT Complete, APT Estimated Index, and APT Jazz. All these products are all-in-one for each type of requirement. At the second line, we have smart solutions like APT Pure, that is air conditioner, APT Fix to algae issues, and APT Sky to remineralize your osmosis water. All these products are very good and of quality. You can find them in our national network distribution in Peru. Okay guys, today we have an interview with Dennis Wong from the 2 Hours Aquas to discuss one of the favorite topics, plants, how to make red plants redder. Let's welcome to Dennis Wong from the 2 Hours Aquas.
Hello Arthur, hello to all our friends in Peru. My name is Dennis, I am from the 2 Hours Aquas.
Thank you Dennis. Please, today we want to know how to make the red plants redder. But before we begin, what are some of your favorite plants?
Yes, Arthur. Well, I like plants that can be grown into nice bushes. So, for example, the rotundifolia species, Latvia arbuta. I like plants that can be trimmed into nice bushes because I believe that this gives better aquascaping choices in the tank.
Oh, that's so interesting. Okay, these are some of the questions from our end users. How can I get red plants like those in your plants?
Well, to grow red plants well, it takes 3 main things. It takes a good lighting system. We have many Chinuros units in our gallery. It also requires carbon dioxide injection. And lastly, it requires a robust fertilization program. While our APT products, such as APT Complete, can provide and cover the fertilization angle, the hobbyist also needs to choose the correct lighting, he needs to be able to tune it well, and he needs to be able to tune his CO2 well. Many colored plants in the hobby are more difficult species. So for these more difficult species, they actually require a higher CO2 level to grow well. So tuning CO2 is actually quite an important part about growing red plants well. It also takes additional horticulture skills. This means how do you maintain the tank? When do you trim the plants? When do you replant the stem plants? Horticulture technique is also very important in growing plants well. Collectively, we call this the 2-hour way. 2-hour way of growing plants. It comprises not only selecting the correct equipment, knowing how to tune your light, your carbon dioxide well using the correct fertilizer, but also horticulture techniques such as when to trim plants and which plants should be placed in which position in the tank. Hobbies can find more information on the 2-hour way on our 2-hour Aquarius website, where we have individual pages for different plant species. We also have a very comprehensive article on how to grow red plants well in depth on the website.
Okay, let's start with lighting first. Is there a particular setting you use? How much power do you use in your light?
Well, we use many sets of Chiros in our gallery. We have quite a few sets of the Vivid 2 here. And personally, I like the setting that is 100 red, 50 green, and about 60 blue. I believe that this combination should be one that gives you a natural look to your substrate, and yet the red plants still appear visually vibrant. I'm not sure if the newest units have the same tuning, but you should tune it such that your substrate isn't too purplish, and yet the red plants show off well. Generally, I aim for around 100 to 200 PAR at the substrate level. I think that a lot of the more powerful modern lights can hit these levels quite easily. I think that below 100 PA, you don't get as good coloration and your bushes won't be as dense. And I think that above like 300 PA or so, above 200 PA or so, the tank becomes much harder to maintain because stronger light triggers algae more easily as well. So I think the sweet zone is between 100 and 200 PA. For hobbies that do not have access to PA meters, you can find the PA data from the manufacturer. Our website has details on how do you exactly read such PA tables. The manufacturer table will generally say that for a given light and for a given depth of tank, how much PA would hit the bottom. We'll recommend a level between 100 and 200 PA.
Yes, higher light can trigger IG more easily. What maintenance do you do to prevent from happening?
Yes, I think that higher lighting definitely exaggerates algae issues. I think that a few things can be done for hobbies to combat this. The central concept is tank cleanliness. How do you keep your tank free from organic waste? If you have ammonia spikes or you have dead and dying leaves in your tank, all these give rise to algae issues. I think that weekly, hobbies should do a large water change between 40 to 70 or even 80% water change. And the hobby should not only do a water change but siphon away the detritus that is at the substrate level. Other tasks include clearing off old leaves. Dead and decaying leaves are algae magnet. So if you see them on plants, you should trim them off. For stem plants, if the bottom is deteriorated very badly, it tends to attract algae. So older stem plants that have been trimmed for many times, the bottom tends to deteriorate. So the top should be replanted and then the bottom removed and discarded. We call all these techniques part of the 2-hour way. And the 2-hour way also includes educating customers on good maintenance techniques. Because only with good maintenance can you afford to run very high light, get vibrant coloration, and yet not have too much algae in your tank. For those of you who are interested in the 2-hour way of maintaining tanks, we have more information on our 2-hour Aquarius website. But the central idea here is tank cleanliness and also the removal of old growth from the tank. Because old deteriorating growth is the number one algae magnet in the tank system.
Nice. We have a question for plants in general. Is CO2 necessary for low and medium maintenance plants? For example, Anubias is low, Luigia is medium.
Yes. Well, the easiest plants in the hobby, such as Anubias, Java Fern, they can all be grown without CO2. Certain species, such as Rotala, Rotundifolia, it can grow without CO2, but with CO2 you get more vibrant color and you also get higher density. Even for the easy species such as Anubias and Java Fern, the plants grow faster and are in better health with carbon dioxide injection. So while carbon dioxide injection is not necessary, I think that it's not necessary for easy species. I think that for the hobbies that are aiming to have color, to have denser bushes in the tank, it is one of the biggest impact factor out there. That means that CO2 injected tank, the plant grows about between 7 to 10 times faster than the tank without carbon dioxide injection. It makes a very big difference, even for the easy plants that can be grown without it.
That is interesting. You have shared about using nitrate limitation to bring out colors. What is nitrate limitation? How does APT help with nitrate limitation?
Yes, nitrate limitation. Nitrate limitation refers to the technique of feeding the tank the complete set of nutrients in excess, except limiting the amount of nitrogen available to the plants. For certain species, such as the Rotala rotundifolia species and Lauriga acuta, these are particular species that get much redder when the amount of nitrogen that is fed to the plant is controlled. For our products such as APT0 and APT Complete, APT0 contains no nitrates at all, so it will give very steep nitrate limitation, whereas APT Complete has some nitrates inside but not such a high level. By depriving this plant of nitrogen, you get a much stronger coloration. But it is a careful balance that we seek to achieve, because obviously if you starve the plant too much, the plant becomes unhealthy. We want to induce nitrate limitation to bring out better coloration, but we don't want to do it too steeply such that it affects the plant, the health of the plants. Our products APT Complete strives to hit this balance point where there is some nitrogen, but it limits it to bring out better coloration in these few species.
Thanks. We have a question about soil. What is the impact of soil for radish plants? Is the capstone formula a smart solution for it?
With regards to soil, certain nutrients are much more available to the plants through soil. An example is ammonia. Ammonia in the water column triggers algae and it is toxic to plants, and that's why we cycle the tank to quickly convert the ammonia to nitrates. However, ammonia is actually a very good fertilizer for plants. It makes them grow faster, more robust if it's available. So the way to introduce ammonia to plants is through the substrate, through the root zone. Why aqua soils grow plants so well is that soils have the ability to buy ammonia, and many brands of aqua soil come with ammonia inside the substrate. So you'll find that for such soils, the plant grow very full and robust, but once the ammonia starts to deplete after a few months, the plant growth suffers. Our product APT Jazz, which is our root caps, aim to enrich depleted soils so that the plant growth can be robust as if it is from a new soil. I think ammonia is one of the main nutrients that you should feed through the substrate, because it is not very effective in the water column where it is quickly oxidized to nitrates. And with ammonia available in the root zone, plants grow bigger, fuller, with better coloration as well. So definitely the angle is important.
Thank you for the tips on how to make red plants redder. The APT products are available in the Data Home Tech and in all our national network distribution. It has been a pleasure, Dennis. We hope to have another discussion with Dennis Wong again.
Yes, it's been a pleasure talking to you guys too. For hobbies that want more information on how to grow certain species or how to grow red plants, we have a very extensive article, in-depth article, on the Two Hour Aquarius website on how to grow red plants. We have a translate button so you can convert it into your own language to read. We also have different articles on maintenance as well as how to grow the individual plant species. We also have articles on how to choose lighting, how to tune your carbon dioxide. So for hobbies that have not visited our website, I would encourage you to please do visit. There's a wealth of information on planted tank topics there. Thank you, Arthur, for this interview. It was great to spend time and meet some of our Peru friends. Okay, goodbye. This is Dennis Wong signing off.
Thank you for joining me. See you next time.